In the previous videos, we found that connecting Point of View to a Do More is easy. You just export the Do More tags to a CSV file and then tell Point of View where to find that file. Point of View calls this tag integration. We also saw that tag integration had some limitations. Like if you use one item from a structured heap item, the entire size of the heap item gets deducted from your tag license count. The way around that is to use something called a driver sheet. There's a main driver sheet and a standard driver sheet. The difference is the Do More main driver sheet can be filled in with tag information from any Do More in the system and any combination of data types for those Do Mores. The standard driver sheet can only talk to one Do More and any data type on that Do More. But you can have up to 999 standard driver sheets, so you can create one for every Do More you need to communicate with. Since the main driver sheet can talk to any combination of devices and data types, you only ever need one of those. The reason for having two different types of driver sheets is triggering. The main driver sheet is updated at a periodic rate, which defaults to every 600 milliseconds. The standard driver sheet has more options for triggering when the tags get updated. You can update on an alarm or an event, or you can schedule updates to do a burst of communications at 2 a.m. every morning, stuff like that. With standard driver sheets, you can get very specific with triggering because you're only talking to one Do More. In this video, we'll focus primarily on the main driver sheet. It'll be all you need most of the time. And once you understand how to set up the main driver sheet, you'll be able to set up the standard driver sheet too. Using a main driver sheet is easy. You just tell it which elements in the CSV file you want to access as a standalone element, and you're done. Let's do a couple of examples, then you'll see how quick this comes together and how easy it is. To create a main driver sheet, just go to the Communications tab, right-click on Drivers, Add Drivers. Select the Do More driver and hit OK. Double-click on that driver sheet to edit it. You can put a tag here to disable the driver sheet. Maybe you only want to access this particular controller type during certain hours of the day, for example. These are status flags. We're going to be reading some tags, so I want to keep an eye on any errors we might get during a read, so we'll add a tag here. This min-max checkbox will change these columns to min and max, which Point of View will use to do scaling in the tags property dialog. We'll cover that later in a video on scaling tags. Down here, we enter the tags we want Point of View to retrieve from the Do More. Of course, to do that, we're going to need some Do More tags, so let's go create some in Do More Designer. PLC, memory configuration. Let's add a block of bits. Add memory block. We'll call it new bit block. It contains bits. And let's leave it at 256 bits for this demo. Great. Let's create another one with strings. We'll call it new string block. It's a block of strings. Let's make the strings 64 characters each. And let's make, 27 of those strings in the block. Great. We have two new memory blocks for Point of View to access. Let's add a couple heap items. First, let's add a PID structure. We'll call it new PID item. And it's a PID structure. Now let's create a program structure. But instead of doing it here, let's actually create a program. Right-click on Programs, and let's call it New Program. Now if we look at the memory dialog, we see a new heap item called New Program. Perfect. Let's save those changes and write them out to the Do More. And let's export the CSV file so we have all of these new tags. We'll call it Do More Tags, and we need to make sure we choose the CMore version of the file, and we'll store it in the project folder so it's easy to find. So all we did here was create two new indexable memory blocks and two new structured heap items and exported the tags to a file. Let's go back to Point of View and set up the driver sheet to access those guys. In this column, we enter the name that we want Point of View to use. We'll access the PID setpoint, so let's call it PID setpoint. Yes, we want to create a new tag, and it needs to be a real. And once we do that, you can see the tag count increment by one. The station is normally the IP address of the Do More. But for any user-defined memory blocks, like the ones we just created, you also have to specify the CSV file too. Tell Point of View to look in the current folder for the CSV file we just exported from Do More Designer. Colon IP address. You can also add a colon port number and a colon password if you want to. We'll take the default port number and we don't need a password, so this is fine. In this column, we tell Point of View exactly what we need to access. If we look in the CSV file, we can see there are templates for every memory type. timers, counters, strings, PID loops, etc. We're going to want the set point of the PID loop, so that looks like it's going to be a .sp. Now if we scroll down to the bottom, we see the user heap items and our PID structure. I'll copy that name so I don't mistype it, paste it in my driver sheet, and append the SP item that we want. And we'll leave this at a read-write so we can do both from point of view. Well, now that we've defined this tag, let's use it. I'll grab a text box, drop it on the screen, double-click, and browse to the new tag that we just created, which is going to be in the project folder. And it was a real, and there it is. Double-click to select it. Let's add a title to this box called PID setpoint. And while we're here, let's add the driver sheet's read status to a text box. Great. Save all, run it. Uh-oh, what happened? Why aren't we getting results here? Well, if we look this read status error code up in the help file, which is under Help, Communications Drivers, Do More Driver, scroll to the bottom. We see error 34 is an invalid address error. Well, back in the driver sheet, that means something's wrong here or here. I got the dot backslash, and I got the CSV. I tried pinging the IP address, and that was good. The name of the block was copied directly from the driver sheet, and I know the set point is SP. This all looks fine, so what's going on here? Well, it turns out that if you have the CSV file open when you start the app, point of view can't access it. So I'm going to close the CSV file, don't save any changes, and restart the app. And sure enough, everything's working. If I change the set point in Do More, we see the results in point of view. And if we change it in point of view, we see the results appear down on the Do More. Perfect. So remember that bit about the CSV file being open. That catches me all the time. By the way, you can open the CSV file after you start the app. It just has to be closed while the app is starting so the app can read all the current Do More memory configuration information. Here I've added the other memory types we created. We're extracting bit 3 from that block of 256 bits that we created, string number 7, and the program done bit from the program module we created. Note that the indices are appended. There aren't any parentheses or brackets. On our screen, I've already created the text boxes. Each of these just uses the project tag we just created. We'll save everything and run the app. If I change string 7 on Do More, we see that appear in point of view. If I change bit 3, we see that in point of view. And of course, the program done bit is 0 because we never actually used the program module on the Do More. The key thing to notice here is our tag count. It's just the 5 tags we created. Now, just for fun, let's bring some of these in via tag integration and see what happens. Project tab, communications, add. We want the Do More driver, and we'll call it Do More integrated tags. Enter the IP address and browse to the CSV file we put in the project folder. Awesome. Now we can see the integrated tags over here on the Home tab, Object Finder. There's the folder we just created, and here are all of the integrated tags that are available. Let's create a text box for the PID setpoint again, but this time use the integrated tag, not the main driver sheet. Same as before, except now we look under Devices. The new folder we created, Heap Items, and there it is. Click on that, and then click on this to select which member we want to use. We want the set point. You can see the full description of the tag here. Now before we click OK, notice the tag count is 5. Hit OK, and look what happened. The tag count went up by 19. Remember, with tag integration, if you use even one element of a structured heap item, you get penalized for all the tags in the structure. Okay, save everything, run it. If we change the set point on the Do More, now we see it in both the driver sheet tag and the integrated tag. The only difference is the drive sheet version of the set point only took one tag from the license account. The integrated set point tag cost us 19 tags because that was the size of the PID structure. Now here's a question. How many tags will we lose if we use tag integration to look at the program bit? Let's try it. Copy the driver sheet version of the done bit text box and paste it over here. Double click on that to change the tag to the integrated version. Now before we hit OK, note that the current tag count is 24. Hit OK and look what happens. using that single done bit from the program structure via tag integration cost us 147 tags from our license because the program structure has 147 elements in it. So if you need to access a structured memory element on the DoMore from point of view, definitely consider using the main driver sheet. It can save you a lot of tags on your license. Now what about indexed memory blocks? Do they have the same issue? Let's find out. Earlier, on the main driver sheet, we created a bit3 tag to pull bit3 out of an array of 256 bits. And we created a string7 tag to pull string7 out of a block of 27 64-character strings. Each one of those only used one tag from our license. And here are the text boxes that we used earlier to display those driver sheet tags. Now what if we do that via tag integration? Will we take a license hit for all 256 bits or all 27 string tags in the blocks that we created? Well, let's find out. Here's a text box for the tag integration version of bit3. We browse to the devices folder now, not the project folder. In the DoMore integrated tags folder we created, in memory blocks, and there's our new bit block we created. We'll grab bit number 3. The tag count is currently 171, and when we hit OK, the tag count increases by just 1, not by the entire size of the array or the block of bits, which in this example was 256. Cool. Here's a text box for the tag integration version of string 7. We browse to the devices folder, in a DoMore integrated tags folder we created, in memory blocks, and there is the new string block that we created. And we'll grab string number 7. The tag count is 172. Double click. And it also only increased by one tag. So accessing blocks of indexed memory or arrays on the DoMore via tag integration doesn't cost us any additional tags. That's good to know. So the bottom line is, you can access all of the DoMore's memory via tag integration. But if you want to access a structured memory element, your tag count will go up by the size of the entire structure. So if you need to minimize tag count when using structured elements, or you want to scale tags automatically as they come into point of view, then you'll need to use a driver sheet to specify exactly what you want to bring in. Well, by now you should have a pretty good idea of how to use the main driver sheet to access memory on the DoMore. To create a standard driver sheet, just go to the Communications tab and right-click on the DoMore folder and insert a standard driver sheet. The only difference is you have more triggering options, and this driver sheet can only talk to one DoMore. So the IP address of that DoMore and a CSV file if needed goes up here. This field is not used on the DoMore driver, and the rest is just like the main driver sheet. What you want to call the tag and point of view goes here, and the exact memory element you want to access goes here. There isn't a column to control reading and writing because you control that with these tags up here. If you leave these fields empty, it means the tag is readable and writable at all times. If you need any help, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support team there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis.